Good morning.
Good morning.
Today we celebrate Wednesday of the first week of ordinary time. Our opening song will be CP first. Please sing.
CP first of the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh in splendor of the Father, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done and gain strength to do what they have seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Since the children share in blood and flesh, Jesus likewise shared in them, that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is, the devil, and free those who through fear of death had been subject to slavery all their life. Surely he did not help angels, but rather the descendants of Abraham. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers and sisters in every way, that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest before God, to expiate the sins of the people. Because he himself was tested through what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested. The word of the Lord. The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name. Make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise. Proclaim all his wondrous deeds. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
and they follow me.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O
Lord. On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law was sick with fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick and with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak, because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose I have come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ suffered. Why? Why did he have to suffer? It was through suffering that Jesus identified with us. This is what Hebrews is about today. That through suffering, Jesus became one of us in a fuller way than he would have if he had come just as a human being and suffered nothing. To be human means to suffer, at least in some way. And if Jesus had come in a form that could not suffer, he would have been quite different from us. He could not be our Savior if he was not fully human. He could not be our Savior unless he's fully divine. When God saved us, he did it in the way of us. Through identity, Christ really sympathizes with us. He literally feels what it is to be a human. He literally feels what it means to suffer. He literally feels what it means to die. It's almost impossible to understand somebody else's suffering unless you go through the same thing. A person without anxiety has a hard time understanding the anxious person. The person who is completely physically fit has a hard time understanding fully a person burdened with physical pain all the time. Before God had sympathy, before Jesus had sympathy, he went through the same suffering as we did. And it's because Jesus can sympathize with us that he can help us. He knows the help we need. That is from the book of Hebrews. The gospel today, we see that identification at work. Jesus healing and casting out demons. He heals Peter's mother-in-law. And he cannot stand by and let the people who are brought to him not experience the power. power of God. Unlike the healers of the Jewish people, unlike the healers of the Gentile people who use incantations and almost magic words, Jesus, who is God, all uses just gestures and simple commands. Jesus still heals. I was recently talking with a family last Friday, and we were talking about healing prayer and all these things. Even though Jesus does not heal all the time, or for whatever reason, we don't know why. In this case, they had an aunt who was riddled with cancer, and they said, "You only have so much time left." And they prayed, thinking, all right, it's good to pray for healing. And 1 month became 2 months, and 3 months, and 4 months, and this aunt wasn't dying. So eventually they went and imaged her again, and they found no cancer. The power of Jesus Christ still is at work, because he has chosen to totally identify himself with us. Let us now bring our prayers before our Lord and God.
That the baptized may carry the good news to every town and city, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christian leaders may seek not their own fame, but the growth of God's reign, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That every nation may behold God's saving power, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick in every place may receive the good news, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may seek God's will in silence and prayer, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Joel Mendenhall, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the death, that the dead may follow Jesus to his heavenly dwelling place, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you are good, you are loving. You have called us here to praise your name. We ask that you please hear and answer our prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May your people's oblation, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore them to holiness and obtain what they devoutly entreat. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His power we celebrate in love, or his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Blessed
is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Humbly we ask you, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacraments may also serve with lives pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn will be Holy Hymn.